Welcome back to the LEC Summer Playoffs, where Fnatic are on match point against Schalke No Fear. And already, ladies and gentlemen, we are gearing up and getting ready for Picks and Bans, the final game, potentially, for Schalke here on this stage. The winner, of course, on to face G2 tomorrow. Schalke have to focus on the game in front of them. Who's here, and they are out. They are done, and we will see them in the gauntlet.
Schalke have decided to return once again over to the red side here, saying that the problem wasn't necessarily in the draft or the side choice, but rather in those first few levels, in the first few minutes of the game.
I would agree.
They got to come back in and they got to fix that, because if they can, and we see these two teams clash in the team fights that we know Schalke want to take, that has got to be Schalke's best fighting chance against Fnatic.
To be honest though, it still feels like that even if they don't feel there were huge problems in the draft, I felt like that picking the Rumble into the Karma doesn't give you an easy lane to play around. We saw how much of a deficit Odoamne was in, and he didn't get much support. In the mid lane as well, it felt like Abadage wasn't able to generate a lot of pressure with his Aatrox up against the Akali. I feel like Schalke needs to put a little bit more priority on trying to at least get Abadage a winning lane matchup. And given that they are on red side, let's see if they can get that counter pick.
Well, it's going to be hard because you assume Akali must be the first lock in here for Fnatic. They do have that flexibility, but looks so good in Nemesis' hands.
And Karma's still available for the side of Fnatic, which is their biggest flex point. We've now seen it flex between three different roles. Two already in this series, and third yet to come. So it feels like that Schalke have no real answer to guarantee a winning matchup into both the Akali and Karma.
And as strong and as terrifying as Whippo's Aatrox is, I feel like you have to be willing to give it up here, because it is not working for Abadage, it is not working for Odoamne.
Are they doing the run back?
They're doing it. They're trying the run back. This is exactly the same draft so far as we saw in the previous game.
I think if we're going to see a change, it might be with the support pick here for Ignar. Assuming Hillsang picks up the Pyke one more time, I'd like to see him get away from that champion. Well, yes, it wasn't necessarily a massive problem for him. I'd love to see something that can force fights a little bit better. The All-Star, I'd love to see him back on its champion that's worked so well for him all split.
And now we'll have to see what the option is, because Fnatic say, you want the salty run back, we're happy to give it to you. They lock in the Karma, they lock in the Pyke, it's an easy choice for them. Now here the Thresh should come through for Schalke if they just want a handshake on the exact same draft. But we saw how that worked out, and as much as you say it's an in-game issue, I have to wonder if more change is not necessary. Instead, it will be the Sejuani here.
So this means that Fnatic's second half bans will focus a little bit more on the support picks. They could look to ban away things like the Morgana if they think that's a little scary. I don't think they need to worry about banning Thresh out. They could potentially look to do it to try and take Ignar off of some of his comfort picks. But it feels like that Schalke expected this Karma to go bot lane in the last game. That could very well also suggest why they drafted their solo laners the way that they did. The moment they then saw the Ezreal, this was a pivot from the side of Fnatic, and now we're seeing this adaptation from Schalke. They're banning away the Ezreal. They could look to ban away another safe AD carry as well in the form of a Kai'Sa if they want to.
And it concerns me, Vedius, because in game one, we saw them go into the Karma mid lane with a LeBlanc, not the ideal pick. Game two, we see it in the top lane, not an ideal pick. In game three, yes, they banned away the Ezreal, they banned away the Olaf, but if Fnatic flex again, are Schalke actually ready to deal with this champion?
Has to be the question on everyone's mind. The Kennen now, the option to take away from Odoamne. I like this, because when I was looking at the last draft, I thought Kennen would fit better than perhaps the likes of the Rumble. Now may just have to go back towards that champion, because Schalke only have so many AP top lane options. And you almost always are going to be seeing this Aatrox slotted into the mid lane, so probably another Rumble game from Odo.
Is it going to be the option? Debating, taking their time, trying to figure out what exact pick they want for Ignar here. Will be the Alistar. Something that you asked for earlier in the draft, Christy. Is it going to be enough, though, into the likes of the Pyke, into Hillisang's Pyke especially?
I think what it's about finding easier engagements. It's not just playing off of hooks, but rather get the All-Star on the flanks. Schalke looks so good when they can come at you from an angle, from behind in these fights. Thresh was not the champion for Ignar to do it. Last game, All-Star is in game three.
Well, yeah. Fnatic looking to repeat the exact same draft they had last game. The Lee Sin has been locked in.
They can't get the Ezreal, though.
They cannot get the Ezreal, so something has to change. The question is, will it be the Karma bot, or will Fnatic to look lock something in the top side? Remember that both Gangplank and Chen are available.
As is Renekton, which we completely forgot about. Yep. Whippo, of course, his comfort pick, his answer into a pick like the Aatrox.
So we're going to see the triple flex from Fnatic. Mid lane, top lane, and bot lane
Karma. I'm sorry, we have basically full comfort on the side of Fnatic.
Yep.
This has Schalke have to show us more in this game or it is over.
And specifically, I think they need a good matchup in the top lane up against this Renekton. They're going to be trying to slot the Aatrox into it. So it's the Corki as an answer in the mid lane up against the Akali. This is a good answer in terms of scaling, in terms of late game teamfight damage and consistent, reliable DPS. But the top lane matchup is definitely going to be in the favor of Whippo. And I would love to see Fnatic shift their focus and play through him in the top lane this time around.
Exactly. And I very much agree with you. I think the big shift we're going to be seeing in this game is that Whippo is going to be the early attention or the early focus, from the jungler from the side of Fnatic. I think that trying to get this Renekton ahead is extremely important. But on the bright side, Schalke, I feel, do have priority in the mid lane this time around. By picking the Corki into the Akali, it enables them to get a lot of harassment in the early game and gain push, which could give opportunities for Schalke to actually play through bot lane, which is how they typically found a lot of success, not only in playoffs, but also during the regular season. So I feel like Schalke should be in the most comfortable spot to find success that have been so far throughout this series.
It goes even deeper than that for Schalke too, though. The early game, yes, they have the tools, but think about the late game scaling options when you have two marksmen on the side of Schalke and zero there for Fnatic. When we hit three items, if the game is even, that is going to be the sweet spot here for Schalke to feel real good about taking team fights.
Can they make it that far, though? That is the big question on our minds. Gearing up for match point in this series. Fnatic were the favorites coming in here, but were they that much the favorites as we expect now, as we see now Fnatic on stage, seemingly unstoppable? What can Schalke show us as we get ready for game three here? Is this the end for Schalke No Fear, or can they take us to a game four? Can they take us to a game five? Can they be a team worthy to face G2 tomorrow in the finals? Will Fnatic find the chance against the champions of spring?
Schalke have an uphill battle to climb. Fnatic riding the momentum. Many people questioned if they would be able to bounce back after the loss against G2, and so far they have done just that. Game three, Fnatic versus Schalke. It's do or die time for Schalke.
It is do or die for Schalke, but Fnatic do not want to slow down already with some level one shenanigans here. They went for the double sweeper setup, and Hillisang has opted into the E at level one, something we see a lot from Rakan going over this wall early on to try and get an early summoner spell. This time it's early vision, with Fnatic looking to close it out three.
Schalke have to be nervous. Fnatic can afford to fumble a level one. They've got two wins up in the series, but the Fnatic level ones are very much a strong suit in the best of five. Seems like they never run out of creative options to find these early advantages. Schalke, for now, are in a decent position to respond. Down a man of Trick steps forward, has the blast cone to escape. Broxen now here as well.
Yeah, if Trick goes over this wall, he's not going to see Fnatic coming. They have no vision. Fnatic just have to wait for that to pop. They now have vision, and it's three members of Fnatic running into this level one fight.
Waiting to see it. Four members now coming in. He pulls through, he gets the stun. Trick has been taken down. That's a disastrous start. Rinse and repeat. Fnatic, before the game even properly gets started, already have a lead.
Schalke said coming into this game, if the level two play doesn't happen, then surely the repeat of the early game from Fnatic can't happen. So what if Fnatic do? Well, okay, I guess we'll make a play at level one instead. And they do just that. They find themselves first blood, and already they're off to a great starting game.
That's the thing. Schalke thought it was going to be that level two play again, so they were starting Trick on the blue buff so that he could get topside and get away from the Lee Sin. Now everything starts crumbling down around them as Broxen gets the first blood again. We talked about the early power of getting that warrior enchant, just dominating the early game. Broxen in a beautiful position once more.
And this is what happens when you fall a step behind in the mind game. You fall a step behind in the predictions. Fnatic getting the better of the team. The hook now pulls. It looks like Ignar in on the bottom side. Trade ultimately seems inconsequential, but you can see already getting poked out. Rek was very comfortable to keep the pressure up here. Now that he's on the Karma, it's no longer about him. Eyes on the solo laners for Fnatic. Eyes on Hillisang as well.
Early pathing from Trick going to be a bit unfortunate. I think he would have loved to be around this top side of the map early on to find a gank on the pushing Whippo, but instead, because he had to start late on his red buff, go Krug second, if he wants to gank at level 3, he's going to have to path down. That means towards his Raptor camp, that means towards the bottom side of the map, which limits his options completely in the early game.
The ward that was sitting on top of Brox's blue buff has also just worn out, so they won't have information on where Brox is returning onto the map. We can see that Trick, only at level 2, will be looking to gain some vision in the river. And it looks like the Fnatic won't spot him out, but he will as Broxa throws this out. And there's no reason for him not to challenge this.
Corki's going to come up, though. That mid lane priority, we talked about it earlier.
Amidage's strength in this matchup for now. Broxah will not commit. Okay. Amidage bailing his jungler out of a bad situation.
It was the mid lane prior you were talking about earlier in draft, Vedius, where Amidage, with the range advantage, can push earlier. So while, yes, top lane was going in favor of Gwipo, it was a much longer trek for him to get down towards that crab. And ultimately, Trick going to pick that up and feel very happy with that change of events.
Yeah, gets into level 3. He gets a little bit more experience in gold back into his pockets. And they're able to get some vision control around the topside river, which is going to reduce the risk of a dive coming down onto Oduwamne. So good stuff there. We're now keeping our eyes on what Trick looks to do next. Remember in the draft we talked about how he has great opportunities now to look to play through the bot side of the map. He can look for ganks, and we can see that Hillisang's not going to spot Trick out, but they're aware of the Hillisang being in the jungle.
Be careful. Headbutt, the flash forward, the pulverize. They're trying to lock the CC together, but Hillisang is retreating. The stun.
He has the vision.
He can get it now. The Amidage is coming in. Hillisang is now in trouble. He's fading. The Ghostwater dive is not going to be enough. Hillisang now on the retreat, though he's starting to heal up. Fnatic are here to protect the team. Amidage is going to retreat. Ignar is now pulled back, waiting for the stun. He will connect to Broxah, but Reckless is here first. Ignar is now in trouble. All of Schalke are now in trouble because the TP is coming in. The Renekton is coming in. Trick desperate to get a kill, but Whippo moving in. A lot of damage going down, and two kills for Fnatic in the play.
He gets him again!
Hillisang is unstoppable in this series, and he will find yet another perfect hook.
How does he do it? Time and time again, it is Hillisang in the moment that comes up so clutch to get an extra kill there for Fnatic. It is Fnatic always willing to commit a teleport to an early play, and that's what they did right there. Gwipo comes in, and they smash Schalke in the river.
And Schalke are crumbling under the pressure. 4-0 is the kill score in favor of Fnatic. Schalke find themselves in a 2.5k gold deficit only 5 minutes in. And again, it was Schalke looking to make a play around the bot side of the map in this Alienware replay as Hillisang is getting caught out. They think they have enough damage, but the mobility on this champion allows him to escape from near death as Broxah is there to support and Nemesis joins the fray. The big thing is that notice how Broxah will use a ward to jump over the wall after he looks like he's in danger. They then use this ward to TP into the fight, and there's no follow-up from Oduwamne. He stays to catch the wave, and this just leaves Schalke with no avenue to escape.
And then that perfect hook from Hillisang.
Blind as well.
How does he do it?
And the Pyke passive, getting him back to high health so quickly. On the verge of death, you see a smile on Reckless's face. He knows what's coming. He knows he's on the verge of that rematch versus G2 tomorrow. Has to close out here, though. Can't get caught sleeping. Cannot let Trick get an advantage here. Reckless could now be in trouble, but Trick is just waiting in the brush, waiting for him to run, waiting for something.
But look at the rest of Fnatic come around on this flank. It's Hillisang, it's Broxah, it's Nemesis have been delayed. They have to make this happen fast.
Broxah now gonna try to come into this one. They have to be careful. Trick now locked up under the tower. Will not take tower aggro yet. Hillisang on the way in. Flip on the top side. They're trying to get something, but it will not happen. Nemesis is level 6, and he's here to play. Man advantage though for the side of Schalke. Are they actually gonna get anything here? In the meantime, Whippo's just taking plates. He's just making money, and Schalke are gonna walk away empty-handed.
Oh, and this is so devastating to watch for Schalke because they had the TP advantage. They recognized that they could set up a dive onto the bot lane, but they don't commit to the play. Now they're looking for it.
Desperate to kill Hillisang. They failed last time. This time the Karma Shield is there for him. He can't make it out to safety. Upset will grab one kill. Reckless is next on the list, so they can commit to this one. Oduwamne with the ultimate trick. Level 4 now coming in. Broxah has to be careful, but Whippo just taking more and more plates in the meantime. It's going to be 3 plates traded for the kill in the end if Whippo can sustain this push.
Schalke desperately needed to get that kill in the bottom lane right there, but even then going to be falling further and farther behind. As Whippo goes between towers to proxy the wave, he's going to get more. And this is the difference between the two teams and how they played. When it was Whippo teleporting into that fight in the river, he had full pushed the wave. So Oduwamne got nothing for that. For not using his teleport, he got 3 minions under his tower. When Odo comes down, Whippo finds 3 plates.
And what Schalke wanted to do by killing Reckless, they could have traded plates. They could have made the teleport worth it. But instead,
Amidage, Sonic Wave comes in, the Resonating Strike, the kill to follow. Fnatic are dominating.
And once again, we see the classic Fnatic. There are always 3 people mid lane. Hillisang is there, Broxah is there. Amidage, he was not expecting it. He had the flash, he had the dash with his W, but it was not enough. Fnatic find another kill.
Go in, Fnatic, honestly, looking unstoppable here in this series, and it's very clear that their eyes have been set on G2 this entire time. They will not stop at Schalke. They are looking for the rematch. They are looking for the chance to get that clean 3-0. They were denied in round 2. have to close here, though. But for the side, I mean, for the side of Schalke, it's 8 minutes and it's a 2K gold deficit. This is the most crushing start they could have had.
Schalke will keep saying in comms, give us time, give us three items, upset Abadage. We need to stall out. But it comes at shutting down Broxah and Hillisang's ability to keep finding fights onto you. And that's something that Fnatic do not look like they're going to slow down on anytime soon. This game needs to become controlled from Schalke. But when your jungler has just his smite, 650 bonus gold, to a warrior on the side of Broxah, what can you do?
The problem for Schalke is that Fnatic are just extremely good at pushing their lead, and I feel that they can actually look to try and secure that top tower now. Of course, Drake is still alive, and Rift Herald hasn't spawned yet. We've had so much action already before a lot of these big objectives have already been contested. So I feel Fnatic's next primary goal will be to look to try and secure this man in Drake. I don't think it's necessarily worth for them to try and trade this for a Rift Herald, especially when it's very easy for them to just match bot. And with Bwipo's teleport coming up before Oduwamne's, it should be a lot easier for Fnatic to force that objective.
Exactly, Vedius. There's a full 2 minute window where Fnatic will have that global advantage. And when you are winning the bottom lane and Reckless can push and allow Hillisang to go find fights inside the enemy jungle, it becomes so, so easy for them to pick this objective up.
Bwipo now chasing down Oduwamne. Battle of healing. Who can sustain the most here? Forcing Oduwamne out, trading ultimate for ultimate in the end. Neither side going to get a flash. Forcing Oduwamne back. No TP for him available as well. Bwipo's will be up sooner. And Broxah once again trying to sneak a Drake. This will be the third first Drake he's gotten in this series if he can grab this one.
So that was just too early from Fnatic. Bwipo forced an all-in top. This does give him a lot of freedom though, because they get information on where Trick is, allowing Bwipo to force that all-in on top of being able to get some plates. They now have their eyes set on mid.
Fnatic trying to match the play, trying to look for a little bit more. The flash out too! Broxah's too clean. Trick does not predict the flash out. He'll get the kill unscathed.
Broxah hits him with a 1-2 punch right there to kick to finish and gets out cleanly. The domination over the mid lane through Broxah's early game presence is just absolutely unmatched, no matter how many members Schalke continue to rank the play. And while he wasn't able to finish off the Mount Drake, now he's topside starting to herald at 10 minutes.
Exactly where Fnatic want to be. This will help them continue to snowball their lead. Bwipo's already almost broken down the top lane tower. If they break that one, they can set their sights on mid, get this Corki out of his comfort zone.
All right, Trick has a flank. He's looking for bot lane.
Looks like he might start the Drake instead. They know Trick's bottom side, but they don't entirely know what he's doing. Herald has gone down. Should feel like a simple and easy trade for Schalke unless Fnatic can try to contest.
And Odo has to back away from the tower in the top lane. He hears that Broxah is there with the Herald going down. And while Broxah has now gone back into his jungle to clear away some of those camps, Odo cannot know that. All he knows is that he does not have pressure on the top side of the map, and Bwipo is absolutely massive. So all he can do is try to wave clear, but really this tower should go down soon.
Luckily. A lot of wave clear in Aatrox. 20% CDR as well. We'll allow him to clear the wave for now, but Bwipo just continues to pull further and further ahead.
All right, so as we jump into this replay, we'll have a look at how this one's set up. So Trick does have information on where Broxah is. He's pretty... He has good insight that Broxah is in this bush. He tries to interrupt the queue, but unfortunately it's a little too early, allowing Broxah to follow up with the resonating strike and then secure the kill with the ultimate. So good stuff there from Broxah.
Another hook from Hillisang. Where is the follow-up? Trick debating his options. Hasn't forced the flash quite yet, but Hillisang is poking at his prey. And gentlemen, I want to turn our attention towards topside as Oduwamne does what he can. It looks like not going to be able to clear out this tower whatsoever and just being absolutely dominated. But when you look at Oduwamne, this series was supposed to be more for him as a player. He has yet to make a final. This was supposed to be his opportunity, but now he is getting crushed. He is getting knocked out once again. 83 games, the third most of any player in the LEC. And once again, he will be denied a final if he cannot find a win here.
And it must just be so incredibly frustrating for him, because it's not like Schalke played through him in the lane phase. He pops off when he is rotating and forcing fights on the likes of Rumble, on the likes of the Kennen that we saw him play so well with last split. It has not been this. Losing in the laning phase, watching his team crumble around him is just gonna go away.
Now Ignar finds what might just be the fight to get it kicked off. With a double dash out to safety, a slice and a dice to take him away, but Oduwamne now looking for a bit of revenge, his chance to turn things around for himself. Bwipo goes in, but the healing is massive! The pull of the meat keeping him healthy, but still, Abadage will grab the kill in the end. Trick's so incredibly low, Nemesis sees an opportunity. He goes in, but he cannot go out. Taken down, the shutdown into the hands of Upset. 2-1 for the Zaya.
Odo finds the flank we've been waiting for to come around on the edge. The shutdown, as you said, for Upset, gonna be massive and critical, moving towards that three-item carry marksman build that we've been looking for Schalke to get to so they can fight back.
At the end of the day, all Schalke walk away with is defending that mid-tier one. One plate, I believe, did go down towards Fnatic and Schalke. They grabbed themselves a couple kills, but Hillesang now has his eyes set on Odawamne. I don't think he can get this kill.
Not going to take the bait in the end. Reckless won't overcommit, neither will Hillesang. The ult, of course, up and available, but not going to grab anything else if you look back at this replay.
See this one more time. It's the double flank from Schalke that they do all the time. Ignar leading the charge right there. So Fnatic take a lot of damage underneath the tower, and then it's the secondary ball there from Odo, extending the range of his Q with both the dash and the flash there. While Bukpo does live for a very long time, he still cannot escape, and when Nemesis goes in for the trade kill, he also will get CC'd immediately by Ignar and donated the kill to Upset.
Yeah, I must say that that was best case scenario fight for Schalke. They landed all their crowd control. They couldn't quite burst through Bukpo, to be fair. He is pretty strong at this point in the game, but finding two kills, finding that shutdown gold, definitely valuable for the side of Schalke. Unfortunately, right now, they can't convert it into that much more map control.
Schalke also spent a lot to get those kills. Flash on Odo, flash on Trick, flash on Ignar. Well, the side of Fnatic really didn't lose much of anything, only the flash off of Renekton and Bukpo in the top lane. So looking forward here, Fnatic still should be very confident in these fights.
And no doubt, the Fnatic are still very far ahead. 4K gold lead. Schalke, yes, have a mountain, but it will not mount for much as they can never reliably really threaten these objectives, and they clearly lose the fight. But the good news is that the Alistar is working for Ignar. Monster team fight from him. 100% kill participation so far in the game. But they need more plays like that if they want to win. Because you can see, well, getting kicked off. Chain CC is there. They're trying to take down Hillesang. But meanwhile, on the backside, Upset has now been caught out. Now the retreat comes in. Whipple off to the flank. Upset now going to be in trouble. He doesn't have the ultimate. It's not enough. They dash right back in. And right as Schalke get a glimmer of hope, Fnatic take it away from the Nemesis stepping forward. Uses the 5-point strike. Broxah, clean movement, finds a way into the backside. They do not expect the kick to go there. Broxah can now go back in. The Sonic Wave, the killing spree, comes in for Broxah, and Fnatic are merciless. They're hunting down the remaining members of Schalke. They're looking for more.
Fnatic are bringing the wave up. They want the kill. Schalke have nowhere to go. Fnatic just need the final touches.
Dage is in trouble. Can they make it out? Ignar doing what he can to body block the wave. Connects. That's going to be it. Blippo takes the kill. Doesn't even give the Lee Sin a chance. Fnatic once again deleting Schalke off the face of the map.
Broxah landing everything at the end of that fight too to follow up for the kill. Fnatic so far ahead right here. This team came to play and they mean business.
Fnatic sit with a 6,000 gold lead 15 minutes into the game. This is absolute destruction on the side of Fnatic as Schalke is falling upon. Here we see them just trying to go for a pick on the Hillesang. Even with the chain CC, this duo just doesn't have enough damage because Upset is dealing with Broxah. He's forced to use the ultimate very early, but then Whippo uses Ignar to get on top of the AD carry. Broxah then joins up with his top laner and they shut down the star of Schalke. With him gone, Schalke are forced to retreat and there's very little they can do to escape.
Oh, the moves from Broxah so clean right there. Not quite able to get the kick backwards on towards Abadagi though. But see how he moves in these fights using the Q forward and then the ward hops to just catch Schalke off guard. They just don't know where this guy is going to go. And in the end, it's him once again landing the skill shots to put the nail in the coffin.
And just incredible damage, of course, from the team coming in. You can see as the fight plays out, easy for Whippo to find the cleanup. In the last team fight, seeing a lot of damage coming in from the Whippo, but there's just so many fed members now of the Fnatic team.
Ooh, Broxah in the enemy's den. But whose den is it really? Well, it looks like it's still Schalke's as they force Fnatic out of their tar for the jungle for now.
Hold that thought. The retreat. Fnatic no better than to take the fight at this point. They're waiting, they're focusing their attention instead on the mid lane. Trick looking for the flank now. Will it be enough? Flash up on Nemesis, can pitch for a play. They're going to try once again to take out a member. Reckless will not go down, however, the shield is there. The hook will go in, will connect on the Trick. Whippo now coming in. Schalke have to respect this. Odawamne stepping forward, trying to zone Fnatic away from his backline.
Nemesis is on his way. He pushes in top, and he's debating whether or not he roams down or continues to push at top. He's decided that he wants to group up with his team, and now the Abadage has been spotted top lane, and Schalke members are very low. It looks like Fnatic have the right set on this tower, or maybe they'll just use this time to secure the Drake instead.
Yeah, without Trick's ult being up, they can easily go back and pick that one up for themselves. Still just putting so much damage down on towards Upset.
Ulti comes out. Hillesang now caught out. The chain CC will not be enough. He's not going to activate the feathers. Pulling back instead. They will not find a kill as the Drake does go down.
Keep your eyes on Broxah moving inside the enemy jungle right now, trying to find the flank with the kick. Will land the Q, but will just have to zone Schalke away from this tower. They get everything. They get the dragon and the tower on top.
Fnatic are managing their sideways extremely well, and Schalke are crumbling under the pressure. As they push out top, they have to catch bot, and they're losing their mid tower as well. Fnatic slowly extending their goal lead further and further. And we can see Fnatic this series, the goal difference at 15 has been pretty dramatic throughout the series.
I mean, just look at the amount of time they spend in a major lead. Almost 81.5% of the time in the last game. This game, I assume it has to be at least close to that number because it has looked all Fnatic all the time. Starting at level one in this game, they have been the ones in the driver's seat, and Shock has just been, you know, in the back.
What I think is important about this series is it showcases Fnatic's ability to carry through both side lanes. They didn't invest a huge amount of resources into Nemesis this series, but when they tried to play through bot lane, Rekkles and Hillisang step up. When they tried to play through top lane, Bwipo steps up. And the fact that Fnatic can leverage this is definitely important, especially when they look at potential future opponents.
And the best part for Bwipo is his team didn't have to gank him. They just waited for Schalke to go bot lane, and he just got everything on the back of his bot lane surviving what should have been impossible ganks.
Yeah, he just got that free lane right there, getting all five plates during the lane phase. But it was also him that teleported bot lane first. He was so influential in getting this massive lead, and as you've seen from the damage charts, carrying in these team fights. Now the next step for Fnatic feels early, but we're 30 seconds off of the Baron. It's been seek and destroy all series long, and the next step is vision inside the topside jungle and pick off Schalke until you get the Baron.
I feel like for Schalke, it's unfortunate to say, but their best bet is scaling. You know, when you're in those solo queue games and things are looking dire, you're hoping that the enemy team messes up on their setup. They overextend, they try to force too many fights, and they can't break into the base. And if Schalke can stall for long enough, there is a world in which they can come back into this game. Corki and Zaya, the double AD carries that Ender was talking about after the draft, that is a window with which Schalke can somehow turn this game around.
And the good news for Schalke is that at least gold-wise, if we flip over to that, Abadage and Upset are doing all right. Yes, they're down about 1,000 gold apiece, but it really is the top lane difference where it's been blown open completely. Almost 3,000 gold between Bwipo and Oduwamne is the massive difference maker. And the fact is, right now, Bwipo can just dash straight into the Schalke backline and 1v2 those two players. They must get to a point where they can actually stop that from happening, and it's not going to come soon.
And I mean, a Fedrenekton was a nightmare before the invention of Spear of Shojin, and now it's only going to go from bad to worse. He's going to stun you, he's going to hit you again, he's going to stun you again. You're going to die. You do not get to interact with this champion when he is ahead of you. Schalke not putting any resources into the top lane will cost them, and things are only going to get harder. You can see the Glacial Augment Karma just making sure that no one can ever sit comfortably in a lane, because if that ghost hits you, if you get slowed down, it could be the hook to follow and an instant death if Fnatic are waiting. Pressure just continues to mount against Schalke as Fnatic have to be feeling good, have to be feeling comfortable here in this game three.
Definitely are. Fnatic shifting their pressure mid down towards the bottom lane, knowing Oduwamne is the only member that can defend, and he can't really do much in terms of that. I'm just going to not connect on towards Oduwamne. Fnatic, they got what they came for.
And once again, mobility for Fnatic makes it so easy for them to threaten the dive, for threaten to dive into the front line to kill any single target, but then to get out just as easily, to step forward on the Lee Sin and to back off. Trick!
Wow.
And that is desperation. It's just maybe now
not over yet.
Opportunity. The package has gone in. The TP is now coming in. Rekkles is so incredibly low. The healing is now coming in to Mantra. There's so much sustain on the Karma. They cannot find the kill. But here comes the rest of the team. Nemesis has to give his life. He doesn't even get a chance to throw
it.
The CC is perfect. Odo will find the kill. And Schalke, for once in the game, now have an advantage. They can do something here. They don't have a creep wave. But now they will with the cannon minion backing them up.
Schalke just threw everything at Fnatic and they got one kill. But 22 minutes on the clock. They have two marksmen and a mountain drake. This is their gambit. This is the desperation play where they will start it up and try to zone Brox away from the pit.
When in doubt, just group mid and fight, and it works beautifully for Schalke. They've now started off the Baron. Can Fnatic even get in?
Hillisang coming in. Who's going to get the Baron in the end? It's been locked up. They will secure it. Going over the wall. Bwipo now going to be in trouble. Uses the second dash to make it out to safety, but Oduwamne smells blood in the water and he is hungry. He gets the reset. The chase is there. They're waiting for the rest of the team to catch up. Can he find it? Rekkles trying to slow down the retreat, but Schalke, they get the Baron. They buy themselves time and they are back in the game.
And now Schalke, at the very least, have a foothold with which they can stand on to claw their way back from this huge gold deficit that Fnatic has put them into. What a great pick that Schalke was able to find onto the duo of Fnatic, and the teleport coming in from Nemesis. You understand the intention. You think that Fnatic is going to turn and fight, but he's left to the wolves as Schalke just tear him apart.
But really, what are Fnatic doing? Teleporting into Kali against all that CC, instantly gets deleted. And then on the Baron, Glippo flashes into the pit after the Baron has gone down. He can't steal that. He instantly gets bursted down and dives and gives gold and crucially experience over to the members of Fnatic. Schalke have effectively just extended this game by the duration until the next Baron buff spawns because of the smart pick and the confidence to move into the Baron.
And of course, as we look back at the replay, you can see Schalke literally throwing everything they have at the side of Fnatic, desperate to find something. But it's not until Fnatic decides to fight back that it turns against them.
So again, notice that the bot wave is completely pushed in, but it doesn't matter. The teleport comes in through Oduwane, and if that teleport had not come through, Fnatic walk away with all their members. They can reset, they can get ready for another potential fight. But because the TP comes through, because the pick starts, Schalke find it, they secure the Baron, and now they're trying to secure some objectives back.
Despite the bot lane! Locked up, Proxy finds one. They're going to look for their eyes on Trick. This is disastrous for Schalke. They had the Baron, but it may not matter. Buys time with the stopwatch. TP now coming in. Brox is still going to fish for the kill. That's the double. Upset is here, but he has to be scared. He has to walk away from that Renekton or he will die because Reckless is now on the hunt. Eyes on the cooldowns there. Has the slow. Fishing for Ignar. Will not find it. Reckless now stepping forward. Upset. Desperate to find something back, but the damage from the Karma is ridiculous. The shielding is there as well. Nemesis waiting for an opportunity to find his way into the backline. It's a split fight, but Upset! He finds the kill. Reckless goes golden, but it's not enough. Nemesis is there for the punish. It's the one for one.
Upset doing everything he can to try and fight back in this game, but it's just not enough. Fnatic saw two vulnerable members of Schalke in the bottom lane while we were in that replay, and they absolutely punished them. Now Fnatic have gotten right back in it. They've stopped the Baron from being a reality for the side of Schalke, once again in the lead.
So let's have a look back at this replay and how Upset was able to pop off at the very end, but how things kind of fell apart for Schalke. You've got to remember that you're still at a gold deficit when sieging onto this tower, and a lot of that gold advantage sits on top of Gwipo, so he forces the all-in, and they're able to find these initial kills. Then when the teleport comes through from Upset, we see Schalke try to fight back.
The problem was they tried to force fights in two different lanes when they're playing from a deficit. So mid lane, they went all in. At the same time, bot lane pushing up. Really clean here from Upset to dodge away and then get the pull back on the feathers for the kill on Hillsang, but he's out of position. He's going down.
And gentlemen, I mean, just to further illustrate the point of how dominant Fnatic have been, Abadage was the first member of Schalke to touch a tower in this game. That was 23 minutes into this game. That is disgusting.
Wow.
That is an abominable lead from Fnatic. And yes, Schalke got the Baron, and yes, they are fighting back, but they are definitely the underdogs in this story once again.
Absolutely absurd, but we have to continue to look at the gold. It's top and jungle for Fnatic, absolutely demolishing Schalke, but Abadage and Upset are on track with their counterparts.
Yes,
Upset, about 2,000 gold away from his Infinity. It's going to be so, so crucial for him. Abadage as well must get to that third item, then they can fight back.
Roxa caught out, lots of CC coming in. It might just be enough. The stopwatch delaying the inevitable. Dashes over the wall, do not think it's gonna happen. Broxa kicking back, he might just live. The ignite's ticking down. Can he shield himself? Reckless is there for backup. Broxa makes it out. His mission impossible, but he succeeds in the end, and now the hook comes in. The wolf will body block. Upset happy to have that friend in this exchange, but disastrous for Schalke. How did they drop that kill?
Oh man, that is so unfortunate for Schalke, being unable to kill an out-of-position Broxa. But also note how they did not have control over the side roads either, so even though they had a numbers advantage, they couldn't convert it into any pressure on the map. Fnatic had pushed top, they pushed out bot, and they had control over the mid lane. So Schalke, they invest all these resources into trying to find a kill, and they can't even get anything off the back of it.
It's just heartbreak for heartbreak for Schalke here. Just absolutely brutal, because you see, they have these glimmers of hope when they fight back, when they find a good fight, often through playing through the fog of war, through using their snap engages to find the fights where they have a numbers advantage at the start. But time after time, Fnatic ramp back up again, getting kill here and there, pushing up the lanes, dominating through Brox and Gwipo.
And now 1 minute to the Baron, 50 seconds. Until the Mountain Drake, it'll be a split focus to see what both teams want to prioritize. Schalke are not far enough ahead. They cannot get vision on both. May have to be willing to give up the Baron. The Mountain going to be crucial for future objective takes. The Corki, on your screen. Chilling, waiting, buying time. Obviously, home guards waiting for the packets to be picked up so they can look for a fight.
Yeah, gonna pick up that package right now. Gonna head towards top lane, but Nemesis will be the first to move. Dragon will be the next point of contention. Schalke, Right now, they need to regain some control over mid lane and avoid a lot of the poke that's coming out, and they don't want to get caught either.
Ignar stunned up. No ulti from Blimbo yet, so the Spear of Shogun is still up. He is going to pop it now. He's going to flash out safety. The TP on the backside with the package. Abadage goes in, and he goes right back out.
Remember that in front-to-back teamfight, Schalke do have tools to fight back against Fnatic. Fnatic, four melee champions, no marksmen on their team. It's all about target access onto the carries of Schalke. So if Schalke can put up a strong frontline, can keep space for their backliners, they do have a fighting chance against Fnatic. And the longer we get into this game, the harder it gets. Fnatic must be able to find flanks to access Abadage and upset.
Now we look. Eyes on the Baron. Double mountain for the side of Fnatic should be an easy take. They lack the AD carries that Schalke has, but can still look to melt through that objective. Will take a lot of damage in the process, however, so Schalke setting their sights on the top side of the map. Ignar will now clear the vision. Nemesis, though, knows he's scary enough to solo force him back. He has the rest of the team in tow. Roxa clears this one out, and Fnatic once again assert not their dominance, not only over the map, but over Schalke as they take control of the Baron Pit.
Keep your eye on where Fnatic put down the wards inside of Schalke's jungle. They want to get Blippo a flank teleport. So Trick clears one away right now. There's still one around that red buff as well. Not the best option for Blippo, mind you, but still one all the same. Schalke need to be very adept at sweeping the backside of their jungle so that they can't have that free flank from Renekton come in.
Fnatic utilizing that pressure pretty well. They're keeping top and mid pushed in with Whipple pushing out bot. Now he's starting making his way towards the mid lane. At the very least, their primary goal is to force the teleport out from Oduwamne if they can. By bringing the top laner to the rest of the group, you naturally can force Oduwamne into a situation where he has to TP in. He's going to go back to base now. So Fnatic, if they want to make this play, they need to try and force it soon.
Taking their time, waiting. AK Goldie backing them up as well as the double.
Uh-oh.
Trick. Potentially in trouble. Hook's gonna go in where he's gonna go. Catches right onto the jungler. This is gonna be disaster. If he goes down, it will be free Baron for Fnatic. But Fnatic not gonna take the risk. Do not want to fight in that funnel up against upset. Three items strong for the Zaya. But if they don't spot this one out, if they don't get an opportunity, TP on the flank coming in from Nemesis.
Nemesis just picked up his Rabadon. Zedgath, that's a fuck!
Hillisang flips Ignar back into the pit. Now they're gonna look to pick off the support. He has to flash back out to safety. Beautiful hook comes in from Hillisang. Not what Ignar needed whatsoever. But they're continuing to take the Baron at 6k and dropping. Are they willing to risk the 50-50? Reckless is getting priority over the mid lane. They're slowly but surely burning it down. They want to keep it leashed. They want to keep the pressure up for Schalke. They're waiting for a mistake. They're fishing. They're looking for an opportunity. Slowed down now by the power of the Glacial Augment and the Spooky Ghost. Looking for the hook again. The Baron has now reset, however, and will force Fnatic back for now.
With no ult on Ignar, you have to feel Fnatic want to find the fight, but not feeling confident enough to start this objective up just yet. Schalke don't necessarily know that, though, without Vision in the pit. They wait until they see members of Fnatic on their own wards. And with Karma in the mid lane, with Nemesis showing top lane, they actually don't think this is coming.
Two-man started up by Alisa and Renekton, and definitely not what you expect. Blue Trinket used, they can see that the Baron has been started. They don't have more reliable vision. There is a control ward in the inventory of Ignar, but there's a blast cone there too. Has to be careful about how he approaches this one. We'll get the vision. TP now coming in for Reckless. One TP at a time for the side of Fnatic. Showing their man advantage, 5k. Can they stop anyone from getting into the pit? Eyes on Trick. A lot of body blocking, but a lot of poke damage going down on the Schalke. They have to be careful. They can't afford to lose out here. They're on the retreat, 3k and dropping. Are they willing to give up this Baron? Trick now stepping forward. Abadage stepping forward, looking for the fight. Broxa jumps over, kicks the jungler right back out, and it looks like he's going to get the Baron in the end. A beautiful play from Broxa with a solo secure, and now the fight's getting kicked off. Has to be careful. Goes right back out. Hillisang now in trouble. Upset over the wall. Whipple waiting, looking for an opportunity. Fishing. No flash available means he can't chase down on the AD carry. Fnatic with the Baron. Barreling down the mid lane, they're ready for a fight.
Fnatic walk away with the Baron and no casualties. They're now setting up the lanes in order to siege onto the base of Schalke. What looked like an opportunity for Schalke to come back, unfortunately falters, and now they're back on the defensive.
And it's Broxa in the heat of the moment, jumping over the wall, kicking Trick outside of the pit, and then following back with his Q on the Baron to secure it for his team. Now a 10k gold lead, pressure in all three lanes. Fnatic aren't slowing down, they're not wasting any time of this buff, because they know the towers are low, and they know they're so much stronger than Schalke.
Now, Schalke are out of time. The Baron backing them up. This is the last hold, this is the last stand for Schalke. Need to find a win here, need to turn this one around. Eyes on upset, eyes on the carries, the double 80 carry threat of this team, of the Corki. of the Zaya. I don't know if it's going to be enough, but Ignar's fishing for the flank. Maybe he can knock Broxah back to the base, but he won't find it. The follow-up, they're committing so much now to the Lee Sin. Reckless over the wall, will get the rest of the team out. Schalke cannot find the engage there.
Schalke just don't have the damage behind it to get the kill on towards Broxah. Spending a lot of resources now trying to clear away the minion waves. And again, because Fnatic only have one ranged carry, it's very hard to actually step forward and put down damage on the towers. Yes, they can shove all three lanes, but unless they're bringing the whole family to try and knock one of these down, they can't actually siege. Instead, they back up for the Drake.
So the best strategy for Schalke here is to actually just stay split up and match. Because of how difficult it is for Fnatic to approach these towers, unless Fnatic is willing to dive or threaten a kill somewhere, they just have to rely on these cannon minions. We can see Ignar going for the flank.
Ignar, headbutt will not connect. Good dash out from Hillisang, denying the engage, but Schalke continue to fish. Odawarmne has to be careful. They're caught out, but there's no damage follow-up.
The problem with trying to force that play is you then immediately give access for Fnatic onto this mid-tier one. They've now chunked that extremely low, and the cannon minion can just do the rest of the work. Schalke did not need to force that play.
The top lane too, getting chipped down by Nemesis the whole time this is going on. I mean, Abadog is trying to do his best, but Nemesis doing so much damage in return. The siege continues and mid could fall.
Trick fishing, the second missed ultimate of the game. This time there is no retribution. There will not be a failed teleport from the side of Fnatic to turn that play in his favor. But the engage on the bot side might just be enough. Nemesis now dashing back to safety. Healing comes through from the gunblade. Odawarmne now running for his life. The Pyke won't find the execute, but it does not matter. In the end, he still gets the kill.
And now with the kill, they can just run on in here. They have the minions with them. Schalke do not have the tools to try and clear the minion waves. Abadagi solo, no mana, can't defend in the top lane. Fnatic are pushing mid. Fnatic are pushing, but time is running out.
No options left. Upset gets hooked, has to be careful here. The Sonic Wave, the Resonating Strike, if it gets reactivated, he could just die in an instant, but Upset still getting the respect he deserves as an AD carry. Now pulling back, but it's gonna be two inhibitors, three inhibitors down if Fnatic get their way. Trick pulled out, Schalke stepping forward. Fnatic know the full 5-on-5 still in their favor. They still have the double AD carry threats, but I don't think it's going to be enough. Nemesis constantly posturing, threatening, three inhibs down. Fnatic gonna walk away, gonna take their time, gonna go for the full clean closeout.
Fnatic trying to end this game tutorial style as they separate Schalke and slowly tear them apart. The base is in tatters. And we get to see this exchange here. Good hook lands from the side of Hillisang to actually start this exchange, followed up by a great kick from Broxah to deny Odawarmne from being able to escape from that situation. Once that kill is done, it gives them easy access into the base and they just take everything.
Infernal now as well, insult to injury. 13k gold lead, and a victory lap now for Fnatic. Well-earned dominance over the series has been the story. Heartbreak for the side of Schalke. Fnatic, of course, still need to close it out. There are still scaling threats on the side of Schalke. A Miracle teamfight could come through. You can never count out that possibility, but the minions might just be enough to never give that chance to the side of Schalke.
Look, Schalke have the items now for Upset and Abadage, but they just don't have the stats. Fnatic are out-leveling them. They have four, five, almost six items completed on their own side, and they own the jungle. They play off of these picks, giving you no room to breathe.
They're hooked. Dash out will come through. Fnatic now looking to collapse. Sonic Wave connects onto Ignar, not the ideal target. Will Broxah try to play this one out? Riffle clears out the wave. They're guiding the minions in. They're escorting them home. They want to see that Nexus fall. They're going to do it slowly but surely.
The Baron spawns in about a minute's time, but it looks like Fnatic don't want to bother waiting for it. They know they have super minions, and Schalke can only hold for so long, but for the time being, they're doing just that. Only one minion wave at a time is crashing into these towers, so Schalke taking advantage of their wave clip.
The double AD carry threat's more than enough to shred through those waves, but a single hook from Hillisang could end the game. Is that the one that's going to do it? No, follow-up is not there for the side of Fnatic. Hillisang loses a lot of life. Reckless goes golden, dodges out the ultimate from Trick, but may just be caught out again. No, Schalke once again can't find the opportunity.
Broxah!
The kick back! The kick flash from Broxah is too clean, but he's running for his life. The AD carries are still alive, they're still untouched. Whippo goes in, he's trying to save the day. He does so much damage! The resets are there for the Pyke, and it does not matter how hard you scale. Fnatic will out-execute. They sweep aside Schalke No Fear, and they say, G2, we are coming!
And with this victory, Fnatic will lock a spot in the World Championship alongside G2 Esports. The seeding still yet to be determined, but they are guaranteed to be one of Europe's representatives.
And to all the regions, all the teams out there looking here to Europe, looking to the LEC, you must fear Fnatic and G2 in the early game. No one can do it better. These guys come at you hard, they come at you fast. You don't have time to think, let alone act inside of your matches. Fnatic do it in three clean, concise, and convincing games, and just dominate.
It feels like every time Schalke had hope, Fnatic took it away from them. Athens comes alive. A clean victory for Fnatic has to make those fans happy. The sixth man the Fnatic team mentioned, alive and well here in Greece. And really, you just cannot underplay the dominance of Fnatic in this series.
And it feels like we answered the question, is Fnatic mentally prepared for this weekend? It looks like that
yes.
they are.
Yes, I guess the new question is, was Schalke?
Oh. It feels like that after game one, Schalke struggled to bounce back. You know, they identified some issues in their draft of the first game. Coming into game two, they tried to change things up, but it still wasn't enough because of the early game playmaking from Fnatic. And then game three, they get routed by even more early game playmaking from Fnatic.
Look, we just saw a huge mismatch in both early game planning as well as execution. Fnatic had a much clearer strategic goal in mind. Dominate through the early game, use your early lane pressure, a strong early game jungler to just get things going. And then they never dropped a beat, they kept forcing fights. Even when things got a little bit shaky, it was still everything in their favor, and we never doubted that Fnatic would walk away with a 3-0.
Neither did Reckless's family. Smile on the face, he knows it was dominant, he knows it looked good. And giving Fnatic fans hope as they look towards the games coming up. A rematch versus G2, a harrowing best of five last time we saw it.
And G2, we asked, did they break Fnatic? No, I don't think so. They lit the fire under Fnatic. If anything, this team looks better than they did last week facing off against G2. Tomorrow's match is going to be all about the early game. These Titans, these legendary organizations, does not get better than Fnatic versus G2.
Now, what we did see was small windows with which Schalke did find opportunities to punish, but they couldn't quite come back into the game. The difference was G2 did. If you make those small mistakes against G2, they're a team that will take advantage of them and will claw their way back into the game. And so for Fnatic, coming into their rematch tomorrow, they need to perform at the highest level. They need to perform almost near perfection if they want to find those early game leads and maintain them against the likes of the powerhouse that is G2.
Then we look at the opportunities Schalke did find. Small, mechanical mis-executions. G2 is a team that will not make those mistakes if they're in fighting form. Games 1-2 of that Fnatic G2 series, maybe. But games 3-4-5 towards the end, of course, critical. If you want to vote at home, folks, we got to do it. We got to do it every time. It's Kia Player of the Series, Outlaw Esports, Broxa, Reckless, Hillisang. There's really no wrong choice after a series that dominant.
I do want to give a special shout out to Broxa because we talked a lot about him as a player throughout the regular season. He definitely has his ups and downs. And I feel that in this series, he really showcased the value that he does bring to Fnatic. I do think that mechanically, he is an exceptional jungler. And I think that without him, Reckless and the squad would not be able to find the same success that they often do in the early game.
Well, speaking of Broxa, we've got Lore standing by with the man himself. Take it away.
Thank you very much, guys. Broxa, congratulations on making it to finals. Wow. How good does it feel to win in such a convincing fashion, especially after last week, and knowing that you just locked in for Worlds?
It feels really, really good winning the semifinal, and especially after what happened last split, you know, it was in the semifinal we fall out, and now we showed that we can perform here on the big stage, and yeah, I can't wait to play the final tomorrow.
One thing that made me laugh is the fact that after all these years, you guys are still able to pull off the level one magic trick that Fnatic has. Is it surprising for you?
Not really. Mr. Hillisang is a bit of a level one mastermind, and he's going to get a lot of credit today, especially for those level ones. Like, I'm really happy Hilly was on our side and not on Schalke's, because he was doing a really good job today.
Yeah. About Hillisang, he was amazing with Pyke. One thing that surprised me coming from Schalke is the fact that they kept on letting picks like Karma, Pyke open. Did it surprise you that they were drafting like this?
People have been saying a lot of things about us having really small champions pools, but even though, you know, there are certain picks that we are known for playing, you know, they don't have enough bans to ban us out. And if they ban one thing, we're just going to take another, and we're going to, you know, show them what we're made of. Today, Karma was really huge for us. We had some Pike games, some Lee Sin, and yeah, good luck banning us out. It's not going to happen.
I want to hear your thoughts on something. For me, this series and the way you won it can be either a good or a bad thing, because yes, it's good for mental state that you just swiped Schalke, but in a way, do you want to face G2 knowing that you had such a one-sided series? Isn't it dangerous for you?
We didn't come here just to beat Schalke. We're here for one thing, and that's to beat G2 and get our revenge.
How do you know that you will prevent history from happening again?
We had some long reviews after what happened last week. We know what we need to improve on. We know what we're going to do coming into the game tomorrow, and I'm pretty confident that we're going to show up this time around.
On this side, a lot of people were worried coming in today because a lot of casters, fan analysts were wondering about the mental state of Fnatic. So is there anything you would like to say to all of them to put them at ease?
I think it showed today that we learned from what happened last week. We were a bit nervous when we were 2-0, I'm not going to lie, but we learned from last week and we are ready to show up tomorrow again. Thanks for the support, everyone.
Now we know that PGL is ready. Carlos is standing with Ifye waiting for the toss. Is there anything you want to say to Carlos about the big revenge tomorrow?
If I was Carlos, I wouldn't bring my lunch money here tomorrow because he barely gets to get into the arena before I've taken it away from him. Don't bring your lunch money, Carlos.
Ouch. You heard him now. Thank you very much, Maxa. Good luck on tomorrow. And take it away, Shocks.
Thank you very much, Law.
Holy.
You know what?